Hello friends, welcome back to Fundutest. In this video, we are going to discuss how to automate post request, and we are also going to learn how to integrate with our framework and how to run with multiple scenarios like positive test, negative test, how to log a request into extent report. So let's get started. So first thing is we need to create a class for the post API test. So let me create post API test. We need to extend it with our base test. Why? Because in base test we are going to initialize our base URL. So in this test we need to only pass our endpoint. So here first I am going to create a test method, and in this I am going to write public void valid post API test. So we are going to see how we can automate as a valid test and invalid test. Post API test. So we are using JSON server for our test. I have added this request into postman. So in this postman we can see here, this is my post request, and as a body I have to pass these three values: ID, title and author. And in headers I have to pass content type as a application slash JSON. So if I'm going to run it, let me change the ID. So 18. So we are getting this response. Response status code is 201 created, and this data we have added into our db.json file. So this is our post request. So now we are going to automate this post request. So first what we need to write: rest assured dot given dot when. So in our case, first what we are going to do, first we are passing headers. So we need to pass a headers. We have header configs in API config. So in header configs what we are going to do, we have default header which consists content type application slash JSON. So we need to use this map object along with our API we need to pass headers. So there are two methods, one is headers and one is headers. So in this headers we are simply passing multiple values here. It has given the example also, you can see here. And another method, we are going to pass a map object. So this is my another method. In this another method we are going to pass as a map object. So we have created map object, so we need to use that method, and we have to pass the header object. So we are going to create an object of this header config class. Header configs, header is equal to new header configs. So using that we are going to call that method. So header dot default header. So this is going to return me a default value which is content type slash application dot json. We need to pass body here. So headers dot body. So similar way body also we are going to pass as a map object. So we need to call body, and we don't have created, as of now we don't have created the map object. So what we are going to do, I am going to create one package which is API builders. So I have already created a package. So inside that I am going to create one class for post API builder, and in this class I have to create a map object there. In that map object we need to define the values for our request. So this will be my body and post request body. This is my post request body. I am changing here to value reference to body, and I am going to return as a body. We have three values, so whatever value we are passing we need to pass the same value here. So instead of content type we are passing ID. So let's say my ID is 7, so I am passing ID 7. Now we are passing title, so test title, and we are passing author name. So we need to use author and test author. So this is, we have created a map object for body as well. So we need to call this method. So again we need to create an object for post api builder is equal to new post api builder, and we have to pass a similar way, we have to pass here also same object. So builder dot post request body. So we have passed headers and body dot, we need to write here when, and then we are posting. So this is my post method. So we need to use that post template. So post, and we have to pass the URI. So in URI also we have in API path. So API path, we need to go to API path, then inside that we have API path, and inside we have post request. So create post, and we have to hit this request, and we need to store as a response. So this is response is my reference variable, and type will be a response. So you can again, you can see here, this comes inside the IO registration response dot response. So whenever we are going to hit this API, we will get a response. So what I am going to do, I am going to simply print a response. Response dot get body dot a string. So we are going to print our response, and let me simply add the validation for response code as well. So we can write response dot dot status code. Let me run it. So again, we have to set the run configuration here. We are going to run for dev environment. So let me run this test. Yeah, so I forgot to change the class name in run configuration. So let me go to the run configuration. Instead of get API test, we have to change it to post API test. And we need to run it again. We have successfully hitted our post request, and we are going to get response. So we have added test author ID 7 and title. This was my title. And if you can go to the terminal, so you can see here whatever response, whatever request we have hit, you can see here we have hit here post request, and it took 4.710 milliseconds. And if we go to the browser, so let me again hit the get request, so we can see we have created one resource. Now earlier we have created this one more resource, so which has ID is 7. Now the thing is, here we have passed static data. So if we are going to run this request second time, then we'll get a failure because we have already added this resource. So we cannot use hard coded value. So we are getting error. Insert failed, duplicate ID. So we have already same ID in our server. So we cannot create a duplicate resource. So we have to generate on the fly random value. So I am going to again change something in my this utility. Instead of passing hard coded value, we can generate into a on the fly. So int ID, and I have to pass here ID instead of passing hard coded value. So this again I have to pass as a string. So string ID, then title, string title and string author. String author. So we, instead of passing hard coded value, we have to just pass this title, and this will be my author. So now we will get error here because we have to pass the parameter in request body. So we have to pass here three parameters. So first thing is, we need to generate on the fly ID. To generate random number, we need to write random is equal to new random first, and we have to import it. So it is available inside Java dot util. Int random number is equal to random dot next int. So we are going to pass some value. So let's say we need to generate our ID up to 100. So we have to pass that ID, and after that we have to cast this int value to string, because we are passing inside our body, we are passing as a string value. So we need to again change integer type to the string type. So we have to write integer dot to string. So this method is going to change our random number, which is ID, to string value. So this will be my ID, the ID we have to pass in body. Now we again need two more values. So we need to generate on the fly string as well. So these three lines is to generate random integer value. Now we have to write a code for to write random string value. So to do that, we can write random string utils. So we have string utils inside the apache.commons.lang. String util dot random alphabet. So we are going to use random alphabet. So we need to give random alphabet, and count is 10. So we need to pass the length. So let's say we are going to create a character or string of 3 characters. So we need to pass here 3. If we are going to use 10, then we have to pass a 10. So for example, let's say we are going to take 5, and we have to store as a string, reference string and random string. So let me print this value. So we have fair idea what we have generated before the passing to value to the API. So SYSO sysout and random int value is random number plus random string value is random string. So we have to pass these two parameters here. Random string we have to pass as a author and title. Random string and random string. So now our request is set. So let me run my test again. Post API test. Argument we have added and let me run it. Yes, perfectly our test is running fine. So we have passed the ID which is 70, generated the random string is this. So we can see here my random value is 70 and my random string value is WF. So it has generated some random string value which has 5 characters. So now if we going to run the again test, so we can able to run multiple times the same test we can able to run. Yes, so second time again same request is running. Now our value is not a hard coded value, so we can run our test multiple times. Thank you guys, thanks for the watching.